Spirit of God, in this season, it will be our duty and delight to hear once more the message of the angels, to go to Bethlehem and see the Son of God dying in the manger. Let us hear and read in the Holy Scriptures the story of God's loving purpose and the time of our rebellion against Him until the glorious redemption brought to us by His only child Jesus. And let us make this place, this chapel, glad with our carols of praise. But first, let us pray for the needs of this whole world, for peace and justice on earth, for the unity and mission of the church for which He died, and especially for His church in our country and this historic city, Kandy. And because He particularly loves them, let us remember in His name the poor and the helpless, the cold, the hungry, and the oppressed, the sick, and those who mourn, the lonely and unloved, the aged, and little children, as well as those who do not know and love the Lord Jesus Christ. Finally, let us remember before God His pure and holy Mother, and the whole multitude which no one can number, whose focus in the world made flesh, and in whom, in Jesus, we are one forever. And now to sum up all these petitions, let us pray the words which Jesus Himself has taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come.
8 to 15 and verses 17 to 19. God tells you, Adam, that he has lost the light of paradise and that the sea will bruise a serpent's head. Then the man and his wife heard the sound of the Lord God as he was walking in the garden in the cool of the day, and the peace of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man, "Where are you?" He answered, "I heard you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid." And he said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree that I commanded you not to eat from?" The man said, "The woman you put here with me, she gave me some fruit from the tree, and I ate it." Then the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent deceived me, and I ate." So the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are you above all livestock and all wild animals. You will crawl on your belly, and you will eat dust all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will crush your head, and you will strike his heel." To Adam he said, "Because you listened to your wife and ate fruit from the tree about which I commanded you, you must not eat from it. Cursed is the ground because of you. Through painful toil, you will eat food from all the days of your life, and will produce thorns and thistles for you. And you will eat the plants of the field. By the sweat of your brow, you will eat your food, until you return to the ground. Since from it you are taken, the dust you are, and to dust you will return." This is the word of the Lord.
Descendants will take possession of the cities of their enemies, and through your offspring, all the
because you have a way. This is the way I thought.
Darkness, the light has dawned.
For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and rule his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this. This is the word of God.
Thank you.
chapter 11, verse 1 to 4 and 6 to 9. The peace that Christ will bring is for sure. A shoot will come up from the stump of Jesse. From his roots, a branch will bear fruit. The spirit of the Lord will rest on him. The spirit of wisdom and of understanding. The spirit of counsel and of might. The spirit of the knowledge and the fear of the Lord. And he will delight in the fear of the Lord. He will not judge by what he sees with his eyes, or decide by what he hears with his ears. But with righteousness he will judge the needy. With justice he will give decisions for the poor of the earth. He will strike the earth with the rod of his mouth. With the breath of his lips he will slay the wicked. The wolf will lie him with the lamb. The leopard will lie down with the goat. The calf and the lion and the yearling together. And a little child will live there. The cow will feed with the bear. Their young will lie down together. And the lion will eat straw like the ox. The infant will play near the cobra's den. And the young child will put its hand into the viper's nest. They will neither harm nor destroy on my holy mountain. For the earth will be filled with the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. This is the word.
Thank you.
and 38. The angel Gabriel salutes the Blessed Virgin Mary. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, the descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored, the Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, you have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel. "Since I am a virgin," the angel answered, "the Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God." And the Lord's servant Mary answered, "May your word be fulfilled." Then the angel left her. This is the word of the Lord.
taken. Just literally it is taken from St. Luke, chapter 2, verses 1 to 7. St. Luke tells of the birth of Jesus. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place by Quirinius was governor of Syria. Everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up to the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for him. This is the word of God.
Thank you.
reading is taken from St. Luke, chapter 2, verses 8 to 16. The shepherds go to the manger. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace to those on whom His favor rests." When the angel had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see these things that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the manger. This is the word of the Lord.
Please listen. The reading is taken from St. Matthew chapter 2 verses 1 to 12. The wise men are led by the star to Jesus. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when he rose and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Messiah was to be born. "In Bethlehem in Judea," they replied. "For this is what the prophet has written: But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out how it appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me, so that I too may go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to heaven, they returned to their country by another route. This is the word of the Lord. Thank you.
ninth lesson, John chapter 1, verses 1 to 14. St. John unfolds the great mystery of incarnation. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through Him all things were made. Without Him nothing was made that has been made. In Him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. The true light that gives light to everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who did receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Children born not of natural descent, nor of human decision, or a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. This is the word of God.
Thank you. Let us cast away the works of the darkness and put upon us the armor of light. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us. Gracious and loving God, we thank you for this evening hour. When we travel to Bethlehem through the scriptures and the singing of your praise. As we move in the season of Advent, help each one of us to prepare our life, our hearts, our homes for your coming. May we be conscious of our shortcomings and failures, and in this given time of Advent, change our life so that we could reflect the quality of you in all that we are and in all that when Jesus shall come as the babe of Bethlehem, he may find within each one of us mansions prepared for himself through Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. Amen.
May the road rise to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sunshine upon your face, may the rain fall soft upon your fields, and until we meet the king, may God hold you, may God hold you in the palm of his hand. The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your heart.